Hello from the Bureau of Meteorology. If you're in Western Australia, this one's for you because we are looking at ex-tropical cyclone Lincoln, which is just a couple of hundred kilometres off the northwest coast of the country. And it is a tropical low. Now, that's a little bit of a shift because there was a chance this could have strengthened into a tropical cyclone overnight last night, but that intensification didn't really happen through the early hours this morning. So the ex-tropical cyclone is still an ex-tropical cyclone, and it's marked as this L, this low pressure area on our map. And it's actually running out of time to become a tropical cyclone because it is moving slowly but surely towards the coastline. And once this system moves away from the ocean and onto the land, any further intensification or strengthening is very, very unlikely at that point. So it does look like we are going to see ex-tropical cyclone remain as a tropical low pressure area as it approaches and moves onto the northwestern part of WA. However, even as a tropical low, we'll still bring some significant weather to some of these northwestern areas, both in terms of wind and rainfall. So let's check out where that weather is likely to be. This is the path that we expect the tropical low to take through Saturday afternoon and evening, likely to cross the coast somewhere between Exmouth and Carnarvon around about 9 o'clock this evening Western Australia time. So quite late in the day on Saturday we will see the coastal crossing of this tropical low, and as it does, it's going to bring some wind, it's going to bring some rain, and we have got a severe weather warning in place for quite a large part of northwestern WA. This big yellow area here is the severe weather warning. Now, rainfall could be heavy, particularly near the crossing point just north of Carnarvon. We're looking at rainfall totals between 60 and 80 millimeters widespread throughout this area, but some places those highest values likely to be up around 120. And in terms of damaging wind, we could see gusts of 90 to 100 kilometers an hour, particularly near the coast and near the center of this passing circulation. That is enough wind to bring down trees and potentially cause some power outages. Let's take a look at how we're expecting things to evolve through Sunday now. So the crossing, remember, is late on Saturday evening. Then this low pressure area follows a southeastwards path towards interior parts of Western Australia. A broad band of rain will precede it through much of central and southern areas. We could see the periphery of that rain band move across Perth, but the heavier falls will be inland and to the north of the state capital. Here's a quick little look at rainfall projections for the course of the entire weekend. When we move from the blue to the yellow, that's 10 millimeters plus. So it's a pretty broad area of 10 to 25 millimeters through some southwestern parts of WA, but the heavier falls, those 60s, 80s, 100 millimeter areas, those are the darker reds, and that's likely to follow quite closely the path of that tropical low through the interior and southwestern parts, potentially clipping parts of the wheat belt. For many in Western Australia, this will be welcome rain after a very hot and very dry few weeks through January and into February. Just to finish, we have got some flood watches for northwestern parts of the state. As we do track the rainfall from this incoming tropical low, we could well see some river rises through these areas. If we do, we'll be issuing flood warnings to give people downstream a heads up that those flood waters are on the way. So if you are in the northwest of the country, you can catch the latest warnings and forecasts through our website and app. As always, keep each other safe. Thanks very much for watching.